remember how if then goes?
That's what we're about to find. Good evening. I'm Heather Englander, and we are here to talk about if then. Cheers. Very beginning of the show.
At this evening's performance, the role of Kate will be played by an understudy.
We see Elizabeth. She says, hey, it's me. What if I hadn't met you right then? What if I had made a different choice? Would we have met one another? And that's how the show begins. Blackout. Lights up on Madison Square Park. There's a busker, sexy guitar guy, playing the guitar, just strolling along. I'm so drugged, oh my god. Anyway, Kate and Lucas, they're in Madison Square Park, and they meet one another, and they're like, hey, are you waiting for someone? Yeah, I sort of am. Don't worry about it. They're like, we're waiting for Elizabeth, because she's coming back, but they don't know. They don't know yet. They're both waiting for the same person. Elizabeth, she's like, hey, I'm coming back to New York. This is this amazing thing. Elizabeth. Wait, what? Whoops, I told them to meet in the same Madison Square Park. Whoops. Kate's like, hey, we should go listen to this busker, the sexy guitar guy. Lucas is like, I'm part of this group. We're like into opportunity for all. We should you should meet everyone. Well, I don't know. Maybe I can think of both. What would this reality look like if I went with Kate? Or what would my life look like if I went with Lucas? But hey, let's see what would happen if I went with Kate and listened to the sexy guitar guy. I choose sexy guitar guy. Listen to sexy guitar guy. I'm listening to this guy. He's playing this beautiful-ish music. And wait, someone else enters the scene. It's a man in fatigues. Wait, Josh. I don't know if I've told you that Josh is his name. He says hi, and Elizabeth says hi back. Hey, what's your deal? I saw you across the park. I just feel like you're something special. I want to give you my number. Elizabeth's like, there are choices to be made, good choices, bad choices, and so, bye. And Kate's like, hey, if I was on your team, this would be happening. And okay, and then we have this giant turntable move. Like, not necessarily rewinding of time, but it's sort of like, let's reset and see what would happen if. Where even are we? I'm totally lost already. So second choice, we're gonna go there with Lucas. Lucas kisses Beth, and Beth is like, I don't know about that. And Lucas is like, oh, I'm gonna get some gas masks. And she's like, what the fuck? So these are the two avenues that her life could have taken. Sorry. I just have burp and it's stuck. There we go. Okay, Kate and Anne, they're all sitting on the train, they're talking about how, we can introduce you to any men, and she's like, no, really, I'm okay with just friends. And then all of a sudden, who enters on the train, but it's Josh. It's Josh, who she met in the park before. It's the same dude. Like, Kate, she stops the whole shebang. She's like, wait, I'm gonna talk to everyone else on this stalled train, since this is an amazing sort of happenstance, a fate, perhaps. Fate. This is a sign. From this whole song, it's a sign. And Liz is like, yeah, sure. So she takes his number, and he's like, awesome. And the train starts, and everyone's like, all energized. Yes, the train is starting. Fantastic. We transition into Beth world. Glasses are off. Beth has an interview. Oh, I didn't even talk about the Stephen phone call. And he's like, amazing. She's coming in an interview. Great, awesome. Beth studied city planning in college. She went to grad school with Steven. This is how he sort of sells it to her. Like, remember, you made all these sketches on these napkins, and P.S. I saved them all. Which is like, I'd love to see those. P.S. You should totally come to work in the Department of City Planning with me. We could be pals. Let's do this together. And she's totally falls for it. She's like, yeah, that is totally why I got into this in the first place. There's a date sequence. Kate sets her up on all these weird blind dates, and she's like, what are you doing to me? And Kate's like, it's gonna be great. transition back to Liz's apartment with Josh. Josh and Liz have this lovely sort of interaction, and then the turntable rotates. And Liz is like, oh my god, what's going on? We hear a buzzer. Transition into Beth's world. Steven comes to Beth's apartment to show her the plans for the Far West Side development, and then Beth's like, okay, come into my apartment, show me. Steven lays it all out. Beth kisses him. He's like, there's all these features, kiss, that sort of interrupts my train of thought. But wait, I'm maybe into this too. Steven kisses her back. But then it all stops. Steven stops it. He's like, wait, I'm married to, what's her name again? Kathy. Beth is aware of Kathy. And Beth is like, I get it. I should go. And Beth's like, yeah, you should. Beth is like, oh my god, what did I just do? What the fuck is happening? What the fuck? Turntable rotates. We're back in Liz's bedroom. Remember that she was having a date with Josh before. Josh heads into the bathroom. There's a door slam, the lights shift, and who comes out of the bathroom but it's Lucas. What is going on between us? And he sings this beautiful and heartbreaking song called You Don't Need to Love Me. It's very sort of desperate and sad, but how the scene ends is he kisses him on the cheek. She leaves. Kate's kindergarten classroom, that's where we are now. And she's like, I'm gonna tell you guys a story about this awesome person I know, Beth. Cut to Beth in her office. She's interviewing this person, Elena. And Beth is like, hey, you might not be qualified, you might have all this debt, but really, you know, come and join our office. And Elena's like, you know what, that sounds great. Cut to Steven walks, Kate walks in. Steven walks in, Kate walks in and is like, you know what, I think you need a little bit of a pep talk. And you know what, I'm going to include Elena because she's here and that's great. She's like, you are capable of so many great things. And you are like the superhero, you're an American hero. You can just take this bull by the horns, as it were. You could do it. We cut to the site of the Far West Side project. Beth has invited her friend Kate, and Kate's girlfriend Anne, and Elena's there, and everyone's like, oh my god, this is amazing, you've accomplished so much. And Beth is like, oh, it's no big deal. Steven enters, he's like, so, the deputy mayor has been caught, I don't know, celebrating with hookers and blow. I'm actually gonna need you to do this speech right now. Beth is like, hey, wait, what? But this is an opportunity for her. Kate realizes this, and Elena realizes this, and Kate's girlfriend realizes this. They're like, guys, no more wasted time. Let's, like, we are women. We are powerful. We can, like, get this done. So Beth ends up making the speech in front of all these people. It's a major accomplishment, success. Cut to, it is a birthday party. Liz Beth, Elizabeth, she's turning 39. And it's a surprise. Surprise! Everybody drink. And Liz, like, drinks, but doesn't really drink. She pours out her drink on the sort of stairwell. And Lucas is like, hey, why are you drinking? And Liz is like, and Lucas is like, you're pregnant. And Liz is like, yeah. Cut to Beth. We're celebrating her promotion. And they're like toasting her birthday. 39 and looking fine. And she's like, I'm not drinking. And Kate's like, why not? She's like, well, I'm pregnant. Do you have a boyfriend? And Beth is like, no, I have Lucas. Lucas arrives at the party, and everyone's like, oh shit, what's going on? What does happen? I'm like, don't. Right, okay, so Lucas arrives at the party, and Beth is like, oh shit, I don't want to have a baby with someone I don't love. Blah, 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 blah. Cut to Josh. Steven arrives at the birthday party. And Lucas is like, oh no, Steven the enemy has arrived at this party. But hi. Sort of split screen, boom, boom. Josh arrives at Liz's birthday party. He is late. He's like, oh my god, I've had the surgery. And Liz is like, P.S. I'm pregnant? And he's like, oh my god, that's sort of like, great, but wait, what? And she's like, whatever. Let's distract everybody with cake! And Kate and Anne are like, I think that Liz told Josh that she's pregnant. Oh my god. But P.S. we should probably get married because I love you. And like, yeah, like I know this and this is real. And we should totally be together. Awesome. Fantastic. Backtrack two. Steven arrives at the party. Beth is like, oh, hi, Steven. Let's go like have some cake. Lucas, who has been sort of like drinking this whole party, he's like, Steven, you're kind of like, I don't like you very much. You and me, Beth, we should be together. And Beth is like, I don't know about that. He's like, let's have sex again. And she's like, let's have cake. And he says, okay. Hey, innocent surprise. We have Josh over here. He's like getting the cake to distract everyone. Everyone needs to eat cake so that he and Liz can talk about the fact that they're pregnant and maybe their future life together. And then we have, hey, innocent surprise, Beth and Lucas. Like, what even is going on? Josh is like, marry me. Lucas is like, marry me. And she's like, holy shit. Blackout.
Can I use the restroom?
Yes.
Okay. So I need to drink. This is harder than I thought it would be.
Act two. Okay, this is a beautiful wedding happening. Who's at this wedding? Whose wedding is it? Who knows? It's Liz's wedding! It's Liz's wedding! She's marrying Jack. There's a major sort of party, dance party in like a really hard 7-day meter. It's very difficult. Cut to, we're back in Liz and Josh's apartment. Josh, Liz is very pregnant. She's like, I'm gonna resent this. Like, no, it's gonna be amazing. Okay, so Josh has this sort of lovely song about how like amazing it is, and like Liz is pregnant, they have this baby, it's this sort of whirlwind. Cut to Brian Park. Lucas is in the park and he is sort of like waiting for Beth to arrive. This girl arrives and she's like, hey, I recognize you, Lucas. You're this like amazing activist person who wrote a book, and I want your autograph. My name is Paulette. And he's like, the focus shouldn't really be about my autograph, it should be really about, like, activism and, like, being proactive. And she's like, just give me your autograph. Okay, thanks, bye. Beth has been watching this whole exchange. She's like, okay, hi, Lucas, I haven't spoken to you in a very long time since I, like, didn't have your baby. But I would like to reconnect with you. Like, what is going on with us? And she's like, well, the deal is, some other me would have had your baby and like lived this life and whatever. And Lucas is like, you know what, that's true. Some other me would have been an amazing rock star. Some other me would have had, but really, I really wish we had this baby because who knows what my life would have been like otherwise. This could have been my last chance at love. And Beth is like, you know what, that wasn't what I wanted and it's okay. And Lucas is like, I gotta go. I'm gonna leave this park. Switcheroo. Liz puts on her glasses, which are hidden in the bench. It's a piece of theater magic. Light shift. David enters on a bike. And Liz is like, hey, David! Hi, where's your partner, Lucas, with my son? Because I've had a son with Josh. Lucas rolls in with a stroller. I'm gonna get out of here. Thanks so much for your help. Peace out. David is like, hey, we should have a baby. Surely have a baby. And Lucas is like, I don't know about that. And David sings this beautiful song about sort of stepping up and being great. And like, you know, dive into this relationship and like, I love you. Let's like do this. Let's be together. Let's have a kid. Let's like do this. Awesome. They run off into the sunset on their skateboard and bicycle. Cut to Liz. We're in Liz's apartment. Josh is on the phone. Okay, bye. He clearly has some bad news to tell Liz. Liz is like, the kid's asleep, let's go have wine. He's like, wait, Liz. I gotta deploy. And she's like, wait, what? She says to him, I hate you. I love you. don't go. He's like, I have to. She's like, I know. There's this very long sort of moment. Kiss, like three or four measures. He leaves. We see him marching with this band of soldiers. We see this young soldier speak to Liz. It's like, oh man, your husband has died in the line of duty. It was sort of a freak accident. She's like, oh my god, like what? I didn't sign up for this. What is going on? And she's like, but wait, I made a vow to you, and we have our children. I'm gonna dedicate myself to these two boys that we have together. This is gonna be our life from now on. It's me and you. She turns off the light. She exits. Cut to Beth. She is gonna be giving a speech. Steven, he's like, comes to see her speech. He's like, you know what? Let's work together again. Let's like build something new. And she's like, you know what, Steven? That ship has sailed. And he's like, have you like invested in your life, i.e. outside of state planning? And she's like, I don't know, that's an excellent question. But really, she brushes him off. Steven goes, because he and Kathy have divorced. He's like, I should have stayed the night. That night. Remember? During what the fuck? I should have stayed with you. Anyway, Beth is sort of resigned. She's like, you know, you learn to live a certain way. You learn to live without certain things. Liz has to learn to live without her husband. On an airplane, okay, a thump. Something is amok, obviously. Brace, please, brace. Beth is like frozen in time. The moment explodes. It's a sort of turning point for her. The plane doesn't crash, thank God. And then she decides to call her friend a little bit. She's like, hey, I know we haven't talked in forever, but like, I care a lot about you. You're meaningful in my life. I'd really like to sort of reconnect. Went to a bookstore or a library. It's a bookstore. Anyway, Kate and Anne are having an argument. Kate's like, I want to get a divorce. Anne is like, wait. All of a sudden, Beth enters. Everyone's like, oh my god, Beth, are you okay? Thank god you're here. How are you here? She's like, I took the train. No big deal. Let's get down to Brad's tax. Brass tacks is that you guys are seemingly getting a divorce, Kate and Anne, and that's not cool. I expect a positive answer. I'm leaving. Kate and Anne are like, we can't just do this just because Beth told us to. Kate and Anne sing this awesome, I don't know if it's called a ballad, but this awesome sort of back and forth rock and roll exchange of like, here's what I'm feeling, here's what you're feeling. Love all you can. Then all of a sudden there's this cross upstage of a coffin draped in a U.S. American flag. This is Chloe and Josh. We see Lucas and David. They're like, that was a nice service. We see Beth. She's like totally torn apart. We see Liz. Nothing that Lucas or Kate says makes her feel any better. She's like, hey, David, you're a doctor. Let's check on this whole thing. And David's like, you could do this all over again, knowing that this was your ultimate fate. Like Josh Jackson, you'd be alone. What would you do? And we know that Liz would choose to do her same scenario over again. Can you guys get the car? This is even usable because I'm really sort of happy. So Liz is alone. She decides to address him directly. She's like, hey, it's me. Same words from the top of the show. What if I hadn't done what I did, which was stop and listening to the guy playing guitar? Beautiful chord. We have Liz all by herself. She sings this amazing, amazing, amazing song about how she's always starting her life over again. But really, every day is an always starting over moment where you reassess. And ultimately, Liz decides that, you know what, it's okay to start over again, again and again. And that moment of the rebirth, as it were, is right now. Big high belty note, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, big beautiful note. Blackout. We're back up on Madison Square Park. We are sort of back at the start. Here's how it starts. And you know, here's how it ends. Liz is there with Stephen. He's like, Liz, I've got this plan for you. Newman Station, let's like get this going. And she's like, you know what? Time is now, let's go for it. Lucas happens to be there in the park. He's like, yeah. Cut to Kate entering. She has this major promotion. She's been named Teacher of the Year. Lucas is like, oh my god, that's amazing. Beth enters, she's like getting the chairs organized around the green table. And all of a sudden Josh arrives. And he says, hi. She says, hi. And this is the beginning of who knows what. But Beth is like, you know, you make a choice and then everything changes around you. There I go. Here I go.
Okay.
Oh my god, my glasses, shit.
Lucas.
Let's go have wine.
You want to do that?
I don't know.
Okay. Don't die.
Ready?
The kid's asleep. Oh my god! What did I just say? Oh god.
Check this.
Promotion because she's just made this major speech. She's taken over for Stephen. She's now the like deputy director of city planning. And they're like toasting her birthday. 39, I'm looking fine. And she's like, I'm not drinking.
She is.